during the break, and we plan on playing the music. As you get out and mingle, as you please do us a favor, meet and greet somebody, try to be somebody new, but most importantly, share the story on how you came to do your best music.
That's
your favorite track. Please make the topic of conversation about do your best, because that's what the night is about. Thank you, and thank you.
I'll start. I can't look. My favorite Do Your Best track, huh? My favorite track that Jim did is the remake that he did of Ordinary Joe with Terry Callier. That is my favorite shit. Like, I was just telling Pace Rock the story. I was like, yo, when I heard it, I'm in my car rocking, like, and I'm going crazy, like, oh my God. And when I heard the flute solo, like, hey, Austin, pass Pace the mic real quick. Let me ask Pace a question. He's out with Yeah, you're ninjas, huh? How'd you do that? Look, hey, Pace, when you first met Jim, did he actually play the flute when you first met him?
No, not at all.
Right. When I first met this brother, okay? All right, when I first met him, we first spoke in 99. I didn't meet him until 2000, right? And, like, he did not play flute. He did not play the flute at all.
Okay? Saxophone.
Right. Oh, right. Oh,
my God. Anything.
Right. He was just showing off. So talented, the shit ain't fair. But look, and so when I went back out a couple years later, it was like late 01, almost 2002, he gives me a copy of some of the new projects he was working on. And like, I mean, this is like maybe 2 years, and then eventually 3 years later, when I heard the track, and he's like, yeah, you like the song I'm like, the flute part, that's me playing the flute. I'm like, oh, but son, you didn't play flute before. Like, how did you go from not playing flute to doing flute solos on songs with, like, really dope musicians?
He found out, I'll tell you a secret, he found out Fat John played flute, and then he was like, oh, I gotta learn how to play flute, too. That's how that happened.
Look, like, he also played a little bit of percussion instruments, too. When I first stayed with him in Japan, I picked up a djembe drum while I was out there, so I was getting my djembe chops up, and I come back out, and he got the whole little, he would one-up you. He had the whole little conga set up in the crib. I was just like, really? Really? There's nothing sacred? Can I have something? You rap now, too, don't you? Don't you?
I got him to rap once.
Yo, the dude was just, man, he was an all-around great dude. And he was a snowboard fan, too, man. He tried to get me to do that. Try to explain to most black guys who aren't good at that. You know what I'm saying?
Stereotype us.
Right, I'm just saying. I said most. Hey, every black guy in here, raise your hand if you're not a good snowboarder. Exactly. That is a true stereotype. You know what I'm saying?
Actually, it's bad, though. I didn't raise my hand.
But I said most of us. You're an enigma. You don't count.
That's so racist.
Pace Rock is giving free snowboard lessons for the next snowstorm, right? You got us. And he's going DJ at the hospital when we're all broke up.
Everything I say about black folks is not true.
I said
I snowboard. And all of us don't like watermelon. Raise your hand, black man, if you don't like watermelon. You want your motherfucker?
I don't like watermelon either.
So it's like Kool-Aid though,
right? I do like fried chicken though.
So wait a minute, quick, man.
Let's get this up away, man. Alright. So look, from Tokyo, alright? Alright, if you had the, this is for the wrist, I think you got wristbands, right? That had the little tag on it, some old lady. Is that right? Yes, it is correct. The number on this hill, right here, it says 386.
386.
411.
411. 386, 411.
You didn't drop off.
You should lose your Nobi Ninja, dog. It's like a little Ruby dog. Right. I'm waiting for the midnight attack on this. Right. Like a little black face.
386. 411.
Caucasian version of that same dog coming up.
Here we go. Alright, here we go.
Next one? Give me this one?
Yes.
We should
So, did you want the pink one? Where did she go? She said, oh, she's celebrating. She's good. She's good. She's good. Right, right. She's already playing.
She go black, you never go back in.
Exactly.
She don't want to switch it up.
Who y'all hear rocking in the background? We got 3, 8, 6, 9, 8, 7. 3, 8, 6. Hey, 9, 8, 7. Oh, you breaking stuff?
Come on, get that.
What happened? What was that? That's a penny. Where did the penny come from? I don't know. Peace, brother. Hey, clap it up for him, y'all. There you go. Free mix tape for you, man. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I don't know if he wanted the dog. You know what I'm saying? It would have messed up this whole thug.
This dog lost
him. He was on this thug ninja thing. All black, you know what I'm saying? Chopped like 5 people in the parking lot. You listen? It was awesome. It was awesome. Right. So, one more. And then we're going to keep it moving. Keep it moving. Keep it moving. 3. Oh, I was about to say, did I say that already? Hold on. Okay, here we go. 3, 8, 6, 4, 4, 1. So make the most of this, man. Y'all might have some long-time friendships in here with some beautiful people.
We're gonna have the ones again, though.
That's the stuff. So, shout out to Asu Rock. Gonna play a couple.